Thus far, we've been looking at comparing independent groups. What about if we have dependent data? How do you handle a situation where I want to compare two means with dependent data? Now, again, the data type applicable is both interval and ratio. Does not make sense for nominal or ordinal data. And a relatively dependent case is probably the easiest of all. Now, mechanically, it's really pretty straightforward. First, you need to depend or determine if the data sets are independent or dependent. That's standard. Once you have more than one data set, that's one of the first things you have to do. Now, if the two data sets happen to be dependent, then all you have to do is take one, subtract it from the other. Now, the order you subtract would be extremely important, and that would determine the null alternative hypothesis. Remember the whole thing with the Vons versus Albertsons? The order that I subtracted would tell me whether, well, that would tell me what should happen if the alternative hypothesis is actually true. Now, once we do the subtraction, we will work only with the differences, and we're going to complete a one sample case. That means either a t-test or a sign test, depending on, again, the violation of the assumptions. Now, what's extremely to remember here is that when we do this, we will work only with the differences. The original data is now meaningless to us. In your own mind, once you subtract, the original data doesn't exist anymore. Your whole universe is nothing but the differences. That's what you're going to be working with. Now, the alternative hypothesis, like I said, will depend greatly on the order that you subtract. So let's take a look at this example and we'll see what we're talking about here. After completing an exam, the professor was not satisfied with the results. As such, he decided to spend an extra day on review and give everyone a similar exam in hopes of increasing grade. The data below represents the scores both before and after. The data suggests the extra day of review helped to increase the exam scores. Well, let's just talk about a little bit here the order that we would subtract. Now, obviously, this is dependent data. That's number one. This is dependent data. Clearly, it's the same source. And here the source is, whoops, person. It's a student. This student had this on the first test and this on the second test. And so forth. This student had this on the first test and second test. Okay, so we're trying to figure out whether the intervention helped. Well, if it helped, that means that the second exam grade should be greater than the first. We need to keep this in mind. So if I take the second, subtract from it the first, I would expect positive numbers. So again, if I take the second, subtract the first, I would expect values that's going to be positive, greater than zero. If, on the other hand, I take the first, subtract from it the second, because I'm expecting the second to be bigger, I would expect smaller numbers. So if I took the first, I'm sorry, negative numbers, minus the second, I would expect those in general to be less than zero. It won't matter which way you go. It won't matter at all. Just make sure you know what it means based on the order that you subtracted, because that's going to dictate your hypothesis test or your hypothesis statement. So I'm going to go this route because to me it makes more sense. So my null hypothesis would be the mean of the differences. I use that subscript of D to remind myself or make it clear that I'm working with the differences is equal to zero. See, once I work with the differences, I don't have two means I'm comparing anymore. I'm simply comparing the differences. The alternative hypothesis will be that the mean of the differences, that's a D, is greater than zero. That D looked pretty ugly. I had to fix that. There we go. So the mean of differences is greater than zero. That's your alternative. And alpha is 0.05. So I need to subtract these guys. So I'm going to let TC Stats handle all that for me. I'm not going to do any subtraction by hand. First of all, these scores, I'm going to make them ratio. You could make an interval, you could argue interval, and that would be fine. But what I need to do is I need to tell TC Stats to subtract these. So I'll go into the editor, and I will select second exam, and then column arithmetic, and then I'm going to subtract the first exam. So I'm telling it, take the second, subtract from it the first, and then it's telling me it's going to store the results in a column called second exam minus first. It's telling me the order I actually subtract them. So I'll perform the operation, save it, and what you can see is these are positive, which means these students increased, these students decreased, increased, increased, decreased, increased, increased. So if the intervention actually worked, then the average of these should be positive. So I need to set this measurement scale again to, I'm going to set the ratio. You could argue interval, it won't matter, that the process will be fine. Now I need to think about my assumptions. So I need to do a normal plot. And I need to select second exam minus first. Now, if you look at this, this bothers me a little bit here. Let me get that back. This isn't horrible. So you could make an argument for either a t-test or a sine test. But just for the heck of it, we're going to do both. So you would draw this on your paper. And if you thought it was normal, then you go ahead and do a t-test. So I'm going to go back. Back, select one sample. Again, we're working with the differences, so we're only dealing with one sample. T-test, there's the second minus the first. I'm expecting it to be greater than zero, so I'm going to make this equal zero and greater than zero. And I'm going to use the selected variable rather than entering sample statistics. I'll update it. There's my p-value, 0.1441, and there's the value of t. So based on that, I would fail to reject and say there's not enough evidence to suggest the intervention helped. Now, if you felt it was not normal, then I would go back, select sine test. And again, I'm going to make this as equal and this is zero. And if I wanted a confidence interval, I could put in the value there or the confidence level. And I update, and the p-value is even bigger because remember, it's more conservative. 0.2744. So again, I would fail to reject. I'm not going into a lot of detail here because we've already done this in a prior chapter. Just as a quick review, the point is this is done on the differences, the second minus the first, the differences, not the original data.